Okay, as my previous video, I have already stated you that how to set up an triangular Yagi-Uda antenna. Now, at this position, this is at the 0 degree angle position, and the reading is 64 micro dB microvolt. Okay, so now we are moving this antenna like 10 degree variation. Okay, so what is the reading now? Like 54.5. Okay, now again moving another 10 degree and look at this. This is at the 20 degree position and then the reading will look like this. And again moving at 30 degree and the reading will be taken like this. We are moving up to 90 degree and what is the value right now? Look at this, this is at 90 degree position. Okay, so the reading looks like 2.8 or 3.3 like this. Okay, so that means the radiation value will be, or radiation strength will be decreasing. So if we moving further away, that means the in the opposite direction, that means from 90 degree to 180 degree, the value is not that much increasing actually. Look at this. This is not much increasing the values. Okay. So at the reverse direction, we cannot get that much of values. Okay. So by this way, I can compute the experiment and getting the readings like this. Okay, so at 0 degree that is 64.4 and decreasing order up to what? 90 degree, and that reading was almost 3.3 or 3.7 like that. And then what do you get? That again increasing but not that much. Look at these readings and these readings, these are not that much of increasing values. Okay, so this is 192, and but whenever we are moving towards the 360 degree value, we get the maximum value again. Okay, so from here what do we do? We will calculate the normalized power. What is that? That normalized power will be from the maximum value will be subtracted from the previous one. So that 64.4 will be subtracted, 64.4 is the maximum value, that will be subtracted from the 64.4, that will get 0. That means at 0 degree the 0 dB value, that is the normalized value. Okay, and then 60.5 minus 64.4, that will give what? The 3.9. okay, and minus 3.9 will be the, so by this way we can get all the normalized power like 42.2 minus 64.4, that is minus 22.2. okay, so these values will be plotted on a polar graph. Okay, look at this again. The maximum value will be subtracted from the other values to get the normalized power or normalized signal strength. Okay, so these normalized values will be plotted in the graph. In this kind of polar graph. Okay, so for this case we are plotting that this is 0 degree. Okay, so at 0 degree, what is the value? Maximum value is there, that means 0 dB is there. So from there, that will be plotted here. And the second value will be what? Minus 3.9, right? So minus 3.9 will be plotted. Okay, at first, we have to check that how much maximum deviations will be there. So we get here 3.7 is the minimum value. That means the maximum deviation will be there, that is 60.2, right? And that 60.2 will be divided into 20 parts, as there are 20 subparts are there in the graph. So we can
draw the graph accordingly. So this is 60, that means this is 3. So this is the minus 3 dB, and this is minus 6, this is minus 9, this is minus 12. Like this we can get here that ekdam just like the minimum value actually. Okay, so by this way we can plot the graph, like this kind of graph will be generated. Okay, so this is the pattern of a 3-element Yagi-Uda antenna. Okay, and there on this is 3-element Yagi-Uda antenna radiation pattern. And we have to then calculate the 3 dB value. What is that? 3 dB means that half power, we have to calculate the half power beam width actually. Half power beam width. What is that actually? The minus 3 dB of the maximum value. So minus 3 dB means this is the minus 3 dB we have already calculated. So by connecting this, we can get these values. So here we can see that 20 degree. Okay, for this graph we can say that 20 degree is the half power beam width. But if your graph showing that minus 3 dB higher, that minus 3 dB will be directly connected using scale, and then connect those intersecting point to the center point like this. Okay, and the internal angle, this angle will be the half power beam width. Okay, so this is the 3-element Yagi-Uda antenna experiment.